Hi there everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today I will be discussing a devastating eye condition that can actually result in death if it is not treated adequately, promptly and aggressively. This condition is orbital cellulitis. Now, you may have heard of cellulitis affecting the skin. Typically and classically, it can affect the arms and the legs, pretty much any part of the body. But cellulitis can also affect structures in and around the eye after initially affecting the skin. So if you want to learn more about this, then please stay tuned. First thing to grasp understanding of is what the orbital septum is. So if you look on screen now, you can see the orbital septum is a very thin transparent membrane, and it essentially serves as a barrier between the superficial eyelids and then the contents within the eye. If an individual has pre-septal cellulitis, then that, as the name suggests, involves the structures anterior to the septum and classically is less worrying in terms of the possibility of causing sight loss and the more worrying complications. Whereas orbital cellulitis, as the name suggests, has breached this membrane and is causing an infection beyond the septum. And this is something that needs to be taken very seriously because it can result in sight loss and other devastating complications. So now that you're armed with the knowledge of what the distinction between preseptal cellulitis and orbital cellulitis are, we will discuss each of these in turn. I'll firstly begin by discussing preseptal cellulitis and then we'll move on to orbital cellulitis. As I always mention on this channel, I am a growing channel and I need support from individuals such as yourself. So firstly, thank you for watching this video. Please do click the like button, click the subscribe button and the bell icon to stay up to date. Please do share your thoughts as well about this video, how I could improve, other things as well, such as whether you've had cellulitis in the past, whether you know anybody that's had cellulitis, how is it managed and how you recovered. So cellulitis then, as I alluded to earlier, is an infection of the skin. The first thing to mention is preseptal cellulitis is actually more common and it's far more common than orbital cellulitis. Preseptal cellulitis is also less worrying, relatively speaking, compared to orbital cellulitis. Preseptal cellulitis is also more common in children, and classically, the age of presentation tends to be under the age of about 10 years of age. Common things to always inquire about in a history from a patient whom you suspect to have either preseptal cellulitis or orbital cellulitis is things such as any obvious trauma, any obvious bites from insects or other animals such as dogs, whether the patient has any known underlying lid disease such as blepharitis, styes, chalazia. All these can be contributing factors. It's also important to inquire about recent systemic illnesses such as upper respiratory tract infections, and also to inquire about a known history of sinus disease. There can be significant overlap between preseptal cellulitis patients and orbital cellulitis patients. However, in terms of textbooks, arbitrary differentiations have been drawn up to try and help one to differentiate between the two. However, there can be considerable overlap. So therefore, these criteria, which I will discuss shortly, should be judged on a case-by-case basis. But classically, the eyelid area around the eye will look red. It will look puffy and swollen due to edema. There may be an inability or a restriction in terms of opening the eye. The important thing, however, in terms of preseptal cellulitis is the eyeball itself should look white. There should be no REPD. The other functions of the optic nerve should also be normal, including color vision, including the appearance of the nerve itself, and also eye movements. There should also be no proptosis, and systemically the patient should not have a fever, etc. Pre-septal cellulitis in most cases can be a diagnosis that's made clinically and does not require any further investigations. However, sometimes due to uncertainty, a CT scan may be ordered to try and ascertain whether the orbital septum has been breached. What your eye care practitioner will classically do with an infection of pre-septal cellulitis is administer you with oral antibiotics and mark the area of involvement of the skin, which is important to monitor and assess progress. Moreover, you may be asked to take daily photographs to try and help in this matter also. Another important thing to mention about pre-septal cellulitis as opposed to orbital cellulitis is the fact that the eye will be in its natural position and there will be no proptosis. What I mean by proptosis is that the eye will not be bulging forward. And just for your convenience, I will show an image on screen now, which will help you to understand what I mean by proptosis. So in terms of pre-septal cellulitis then, compared to orbital cellulitis, a few arbitrary distinctions that can help diagnostically include assessing visual acuity, which may be reduced in orbital cellulitis, but will tend to be normal in preceptor. In orbital cellulitis, the pupils may be affected and there may be an ROPD, whereas this will probably not be the case in preceptor cellulitis. The optic nerve head itself will look normal in preceptor cellulitis. However, it will potentially be swollen in an orbital cellulitis. Eye movements in orbital cellulitis will potentially be restricted and there may be double vision. Color vision may be reduced in orbital cellulitis and there will potentially be proptosis in orbital cellulitis. The key thing to remember, however, with all of these statements that I've just made is that there could be significant overlap and a patient may actually be progressing from a preceptal picture into an orbital cellulitis picture and therefore they need to be monitored and watched closely. And that's why such patients classically have daily reviews by their eye care practitioners. So moving on to orbital cellulitis then, because it is a much more aggressive and serious condition, it classically is managed by not just an eye care doctor, but also ENT specialists and sometimes maxillofacial doctors also. Classically, orbital cellulitis is caused by a variety of different possible bacteria, including staph and strep. The risk factors for orbital cellulitis are similar to preceptor, but in addition to the things mentioned for preceptor, one should ascertain whether patients have recently had any surgery, because this will create a potential natural passage into the eye secondary to such an event. There may be a retained foreign body which should be explored, and sinus disease is the big risk factor for orbital cellulitis. In some instances, orbital cellulitis can be endogenous, which basically means there's an infection elsewhere in the body which has spread to the orbit. Therefore, systemic evaluation is important. Patients with orbital cellulitis typically tend to look unwell compared to a preceptal cellulitis patient. They may have fevers, they may feel generally unwell, have malaise, tiredness, fatigue. Their eyeball may look red, angry, their eye may be bulging forward, they may have double vision, restricted eye movements, and they may be complaining of reduced or poor vision. In addition to their optic nerve head function being compromised and therefore causing reduced vision, if they have issues with closing their eye, they may have dryness issues on the surface of their eye, their pressure within their eye may be elevated, they're at risk of clots such as central retinal artery occlusions, and more seriously, the big complications that patients with orbital cellulitis can get include abscess formation, include thromboses, and also include meningitis and even cerebral abscesses. This is why such patients require blood tests, they require blood cultures, they require monitoring of their observations, they are usually admitted to the hospital wards for careful evaluation and aggressive treatment. Such patients will receive IV or intravenous antibiotic treatment, and classically this will be with multiple agents to try and hit the infection hard, as it were. And as mentioned, careful observation and evaluation will ensure that nil deterioration is missed. Therefore, daily reviews happen for such patients. One of the key investigations that patients will have for orbital cellulitis is a CT scan of the face and head to try and understand the extent to which the infection is progressing in and around the eye and then further back towards the brain itself. Thank you so much for watching this video about pre-septal and orbital cellulitis. We've discussed in this video what the orbital septum is, what the key features for both pre-septal and orbital cellulitis are, how such patients present, how they're investigated, and how they're managed. If you've liked this video, then as mentioned earlier, please do click the like button, please do click on the subscribe button, and please do click on the bell icon. Until next time, thank you very much.